offensively for Denver. So Cincinnati faces a 3rd and 9. We've got 6:36 and counting left in this first half.
Bengals 2 of 4 this afternoon on 3rd downs. Coming in, they were just 25% converting. Part of that because they faced a lot of 3rd and longs in the first 2 games against the Jets and Steelers.
5 receivers set, 6 defensive backs for Denver. A bullet from Dalton, 22-yard BB.
It's too deep, so that means the tight end is going to get right down the middle. Dalton sees the coverage there by T.J. Ward.
Backflip, ladies and gentlemen, what you think about that? And let me tell you one more thing. He is still riding his amateur bowl. This is only 900cc motor in that thing.
That's correct.
Imagine that. Here we go. Nice flare. 450 into backflip, into 180, into backflip. Once again, backflip, backflip. Oh, look at that. Into a 360 and into a barrel roll. And backflip again. Backflip again. Now back. 270 into barrel roll again. And into backflip coming out of the footage. You heard the noise. Last 15 seconds already going, but he's on fire. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to squeeze one more in. That's it. Make some noise for Chris Langlands, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow, Chris Langlands out of Florida laying down an awesome routine. A lot of combinations in there. And Iceman, what are all of they looking for?
Oh, the judges are looking for, let me take out my smartphone out of my pocket, because believe it or not, it's actually seven criterias which I need to look for. It's going to take I have to take a picture of it because obviously my brain doesn't work that good.
I'll tell you what, while you're doing that, I'll go ahead and get us ready with the next ride, and that is going to be Taji Yamamoto. He is out of Tanzania, Japan. He's sponsored by Bun Freestyle, Wiki Sense, and Elf. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our next competitor right here, Pro Freestyle. Good
hey,
job.
I got those criterias right away. So our judges are judging on style, degree of a difficulty, amplitude, originality, continuity, variety, and the number of successfully completed maneuvers. So that is what it is. 7 aspects, style, degree of difficulty, amplitude, originality, continuity, variety, and the number of successfully completed maneuvers or tricks. The talent tournament freestyle. I'm not quite sure if we are waiting for the scores to be announced. Standing by. So let's.
I actually called the next guys out. So if they are ready.
Okay, we still have 15 competitors to go through. We already saw Chris Miles in his 60 seconds of round 1.
Yes.
Of a pro freestyle competition. And this year, we are going to have a 3 rounds of a freestyle pro competition. The first one is only 60 seconds. The second, oh, look at that. I believe Taji is taking over the water. So our next competitor coming all the way from Tsuyama, Japan, Taji Yamamoto, is going on the water. He's riding for a pro freestyle elf and wake stands. Please put your hands together for your next competitor, Taji Yamamoto, all the way from Japan. So once again, whenever he's ready, he's gonna make a first wake setup, or he starts his first trick, and that's when we're gonna start a clock count of 60 seconds. It's not 1 minute, it's 60 seconds.
And what they're doing today is they're actually qualifying for position for tomorrow.
Okay, and it looks like our rider is almost ready. All eyes on the water, judges and the spectators. Let's take a look at that. Here we go, first wake setup. Didn't like that one, but go now. That's a great thing about the first wake setup, you know.
He can actually,
I think he can do it all day.
I think so too.
He most probably gonna run out of the fuel, but in the theory he can, so let's see. So first wake setup. Look at that! no-footer right there. What do you think about that, huh? Now that is a freestyle motocross underwater. Oh yeah, he wants to hear you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Taji Yamamoto. No leg backflip into another backflip. Into a 360, into another 360. Now into a backflip. Look at that. Woohoo! It's Taji Yamamoto, your second competitor today on the water. Here we go. Another huge backflip, over rotation, look back backflip, another backflip, into a 360 to the left, and into the backflip, backflip, another backflip. Look at that, what you think about that having to last 15 seconds now? Aaron Barrow from nothing, no way, Aaron Barrow. Looks like he's happy with that. Let's see if he can squeeze one more in or up. He's right in the shallows. I don't think he'll be able to squeeze the one in. Oh, yeah, right now. Oh, look at that one hand, look back, point back, backflip. Nicely done.
Beautiful flair on that. Again, you are watching the young man out of Japan. He's sponsored by Fun Freestyle, Quakey Sense, and Elf. That is Taji Yamamoto. Put your hands together for him.
So, okay, ladies and gentlemen, this was your second competitor, but let me go back to the first one, because we do have a score for Chris Lineless, currently in the lead, the only one with the score, 43.6 is a score to remember for Chris Lineless, your first competitor. Our next competitor is going to be Mark Gomez.
He is out of Fullerton, California, sponsored by KMG Racing, HydroTurf, Mystic Lubricant. And he is actually aboard the brand new RRP Freeride boat. I had just started testing that this week, I think, and had decided, hey, you know what? I want to take this into competition. He didn't even know he was going to compete this week, and I liked this boat so much, he said, yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, so Mark is going to take over in a minute. We just need to gather all the points from the judges so they can focus on him. But truth to be said, then it's a very good point that he is actually competing on the boat, which is not necessarily made for flat water freestyle. It's actually a freeride boat. It's a Richter XFR, and it has only, I would say only, 1,000cc motor in it, so he's a little underpowered, but you know what, he's having a blast. He's like, you know what, I might as well go for it. So that has written Mark Gomez all over it anyway. And by the way, this guy is 2015 IFWA Freeride World Champion. Imagine that. He said, you know, one title is not enough, I might as well try to get my hands on that fly water one too.
That is correct. They did the entire tour for the IFWA as Mark Gomez gets warmed up. That tour included Portugal, ending at the Surfslam right in Portland, Oregon. Just happened a couple of weeks ago. And he is in some pretty august company as the Zach Bright down there, who is also a champion in the IFWA. He won the Surfslam this year.
Looks like he's getting ready on his Richter. And here we go, circling back, all eyes on the water, judges and the crowd. Who's back there, one footer, one hander, what do you think about that? I thought they called that 50-50 in a free ride. Or was it Madonna? I didn't quite saw if he put, was it Madonna? It was Madonna. All right, the trick was done first by Madonna, so that's why it's called after her. He's going after, but look at that. Look at the aerial barrel over the buoy over there, nicely done. You can tell he's a stuntman in a water war show, right? Okay, which actually he is. Look at that no-hand aerial barrel. Woohoo! That's Mark Gomez, ladies and gentlemen, bringing the free ride to flat water freestyle on that Richter XFR. Here we go, turning back towards the wake. Aerial barrel. And in 360 to the opposite, look at that, last 15 seconds to go for Mark Gomez. Once again, this is only 60 seconds, the round one is only 60 seconds, 1 minute. Huge backflip, it's the second one. Still got counted because he started that trick on a combo before he ran out of the time.
All right,
he started to breathe though.
Yeah, that was really awesome. Just 1 minute on these routines out of Fullerton, California. Put your hands together for Mark Gomez. And that was just gratuitous for the crowd. He just wants to get you guys fired up. A lot of fun to watch.
He's having a blast, that's for sure. Mark Gomez, 2015 IFWA World Free Ride Champion, going for that five-order title.
Hey, you guys, by the way, if you're hungry, we've got authentic American Indian tacos and fry bread right down here as well at one of the vendors. So help yourself. Don't forget to grab a little something to eat. And also don't forget some sunscreen.
Yeah, very true. I got burned last night. By the way, going back to Taji Yamamoto, his scores for his first run or first round of 2015 IGSBA Pro Freestyle Competition is 43.5. So that means we still have him in the second position. We still have three finalists as a leader after that from Taji Yamamoto. Obviously, we still don't have the scores for Mark Gomez. But now, we have a next competitor on the
water. He is out of Dubai, the United Arab Emirates. He's sponsored by Skydive Dubai and Extreme. That is Rashid Al-Mullah. Gentleman, by the way, that has been competing for 4 years. He is a two-time champion from the Dubai Tour. This is his first time as a pro, however, at the World Finals.
This is his first time on this 1200cc Team Extreme Build Machine. He's also a user there at home, which is the one which you're gonna see a plenty of today and tomorrow. So please call the owner Rashid Al-Mullah. And this guy is known for his endless gumbo. Here we go. Look at that nose grabber barrel into a hoot grabber backflip. Another hoot grabber backflip into a 360. Another 360 into backflip. Into a 360 and backflip right there. Another 360 and backflip. 360 to the left and backflip again. Now a 360 to the right, down to the left. Check this out. Coming to the end with two backflips in the head. Now 360 to the left. Another backflip. Another backflip. 360 and a backflip.
Rashid Al-Mullah.
Unbelievable run. Rashid Al-Mullah riding for a Skydive D5 and Team Extreme. The last and his first 60 seconds off blue water time. Oh, it looks like he's going to give you some more, guys. This is just for you. Loop that backflip into a nice 360 backflip. Sorry. Barrel into a backflip, and another backflip, and another backflip. Backflipping his way towards the crowd right here in the Lake Havasu. Nicely done. Rashid Al-Mullah, ladies and gentlemen. In the meanwhile, we have a score for Mark Gomez. So the scores for Mark Gomez are going to be 42.0. 42.0 coming in the third position. Still have Chris Vineland in the first. Taji Yamamoto in second and Mark Gomez in third. And now we're going to have the scores for Rashid Al-Mullah. Now we're just going to wait for
Tell you what, while you're waiting there, Iceman, I got a couple more t-shirts from Yamaha. How about we take care of our crowd here? What do you guys think? All right, we got more t-shirts from Yamaha coming at you.
There you go. More t-shirts coming at you. Jersey is gonna give you some love. Right away. Yamaha. Team Home.
See, you guys have been so good to us, we thought we better take care of you too. All right, and while you guys are getting some love from the tower, Tanner Thomas is getting ready for his routine. He is sponsored by BAM, Tyler Reynolds, TC Freeride, Richter, Dazza, Scat Track. He's out of Ketchikan, Alaska, which is actually an island. And we actually stole him from Freeride, and that was originally what he did. And now he has switched over into freestyle. And you want to know why, Iceman? He gave me three reasons. He said, I want to go big, and in freestyle I can.
He's about ready. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Huge 360 aerial barrel into a backflip. Into a 360. Into another backflip. Now 180 into a backflip. Check this out. Tanner Thomas opening combo. This is your 2015 amateur world champion. He won yesterday, and you know what? Just hop on and out their boats, and he's going to give other guys run for the money for the big title of pro freestyle today. Another wakes it up. Use 360 loop back into a backflip. Flat 180 into a backflip. Another backflip. Another backflip. Another backflip. Woo-hoo! Check this out. This guy is smooth like a butter. Let me tell you that.
By the way, this is his premiere, his debut, if you will, up into the pro ranks. Again, he won that amateur freestyle title just yesterday right here on the waters for the 2006 World Finals. And that is going to be a wrap, as they say, for his routine. The rest of that is gratuitous barrel roll into a backflip, goes into a back 360. All right, you guys, one more time, put your hands together for him, Tanner Thomas.
Right on, and meanwhile, we do have a score for Rashid Al-Ghula. So ladies and gentlemen, guess what? We do have a new leader, because Rashid Al-Ghula takes the number one spot for now with a score of 44.5. So now we have a 44.5 in the lead, Rashid Al-Ghula in the second place, Chris Lyman with a 43.6. And in third place currently is Taji Yamamoto with 43.5. These are your top three, and we're gonna gather the scores of the judges for Tanner Thomas, and we're gonna move to another competitor, which actually competed yesterday in amateur freestyle also, and he is your vice amateur freestyle champion for 2015, so he decided to step it up again as well.
That's pretty cool. He's out of Chicago, Illinois, and as he gets prepped, I'll tell you about him. He's sponsored by Evolve Motors and X-Screen Inc. It is Jason Woodes. And he is just about to put that boat in the water. I'm actually looking for it down the... Oh, there it is. It's hard to miss, right? Because this guy is not afraid to wear pink. Because it's manly. And I'll tell you what, when you see how high he goes, you'll see what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah. You know, pink is too black. That's what's up.
That's awesome. I see Jason Stoyer down there as well. Did you see him, buddy?
Stoyer is new black. Of course. Here we go. Looks like Jason Woodes is getting ready. He is actually also on his amateur boat. I don't think he swapped the motor. It's definitely the hull he was on yesterday. And I have a feeling that he is also on the 900cc power plant.
His brother also competes in freestyle. That's Michael Woodes. Michael actually, not the older brother, but between the two of them, he said he was the more wild brother. But I tell you, once you watch this guy out on the water, I find that to be a bit debatable.
You know, yesterday in 2 minutes, he was able to do 35 tricks. 35 tricks in 2 minutes. So this guy loves his combos. So keep your eyes on the water, ladies and gentlemen, because, you know, with the blink of an eye, you can miss.
That's right. Seems pretty rowdy to me.
Getting ready for this setup winner. First trick. That's when we're going to start the countdown. Here we go. Huge 360 into another 360. Another 360 into a backflip. Into a 360 to the left. Another 360 to the left. Another 180 now. Into backflip. Another backflip. Into 360 to the left. Another 360 to the left. Into a backflip again. Into shallows. Look how that water just turned.
Yeah, what Iceman's referring to is it's so shallow, the intake rate is actually pulling the mud up from the bottom. You guys are running all that at about, 6 feet of water at the moment. That's pretty aggressive.
It is. And now to wake it up for Jason with his one-hand aerial barrel roll into a flat 360, into 180, into the opposite 180, into another opposite 180, into another 180, and back. But look at that. Lefty, righty, into 180. Another
Got a lot of riders with that same exact goal in mind right out here for the 2015 Quickie Sense World Finals. Don't forget to drop by Vendor Rally this afternoon and get hooked up with all your Quickie Sense gear. Again, special thanks to Quickie Sense. All right, we're still waiting for those scores. I think Iceman just stepped back for that. Also want to encourage you guys, don't forget to get your IJSBA official gear right here at Shirtworks. We've got a ton of great vendors back there. I see Rag Freeform, who, by the way, introduced their brand new hull right at Searchland this year. And they also brought that hull right here to the World Finals. And there has been a ton of very innovative products, of products that you've never seen before. And not to name drop, but Rick Roy actually just showed you one of them, and that was that brand new Freeride hull and that Freeride boat that Mark Gomez was on. So don't forget to go buy Rick Roy products and check out that new Freeride hull that Rick Roy and his gang put together. Welcome back, buddy.
Well, I was just checking on the scores, and I do have a score for Tanner Thomas. His score is 43.55, which actually right now as it is, I believe he's putting in fourth position it is, but this is only the first round of obviously 2015 IGSB Pro Freestyle Competition. Right now we have a Rashid Amuda in 40 with 45.5, that's his official score, 45.5, Rashid Amuda in first, then we have Chris Limelitz in 43, and you know what, Tanner Thomas is in third with 43.55, because in fourth you have Akaji Yamamoto with 43.50.
All right, well, here's who's next on the water. Dan, he is out of the United Kingdom. He's sponsored by Water Dog, Customize, and Job Sports, Avos Water Sports in Denmark. And his name is Jonathan Kavanaugh.
Oh, yeah, he hangs out with the Queen every week. That's how cool he is. And you know what? Keep your eyes on the water, because this guy goes big and loves the combos.
Well, you would know all about that. He actually won in Poland for the Euro Finals. He's a two-time British national champion. And, he is incredible. And as soon as I said that, those guys were like, oh, yeah, that's our guy.
That's our guy. Here we go. 24. Look at that huge 540 into a backflip. Into backflip.
Exactly the same thing that I thought when I saw him over in Poland. You need to get over to the World Finals, and now you guys can see why. And I tell you what, not only did he come out here ready to compete, but he has an entire team down there to help him. Put your hands together one more time, Jonathan Kavanaugh.
I just wanted to point out one thing that last couple of
weeks
started in the opening up with the Scarecrow
Aaron Rivero,
which is the hardest. You know, it's one of the hottest tricks in the book right now because what you're doing, you are actually taking both of your handles off your handlebars and you hold it to the seat just with one foot. So you have literally both hands off, one foot off, and now who did the scarecrow first? Also a British competitor, which actually is going to be going out last today because he's going to be defending his last year world, you know, title.
Congratulations once again to Lee Stone. And also a great job for Jonathan Kavanaugh. And we have got more coming at you. We're just getting these scores for Jonathan. But I guess we'll go ahead and get ready with our next rider and have him get prepped. Gentleman comes from, well, wait, I'm going to wait until Simon calls
him. I do have a score for it. Jason Winters. Let's do that. So Jason Winters' score is 43.3 for you guys who are keeping a track of that. Still doesn't change out our top three because our top three as of right now is Rashid Al-Mura with 45.5. After that, we do have Tanner Thomas with a 43.55. And after that, there's Chris Lindley. I'm sorry, Chris Lindley is in second now. And Tanner Thomas is in third with 43.55. So Rashid Al-Mura, Chris Lindley, and Tanner Thomas right now, that is your top three of round one of 2015 Pro Freestyle Competition. While we're waiting on the scores for Jonathan Kavanaugh, I'm going to say something, a little something about our next competitor. He's coming all the way from Belgium. And his name is Tom the Cutter. He is a veteran freestyler from Europe. Awesome guy. Did the European tour this year. Showed up at our first round. You know what? This guy is a DJ. That's what he does. He actually owns a dance club in Belgium. This is called Barracuda. So I'm just gonna say a big shout out because I'm sure these guys are watching right now. They're boss, and he's a DJ. And you know what? Well, our competition usually happens on Saturday, and he DJed through a whole Friday night, slept a couple hours, drove to the competition, did the competition, went back home, and then DJed next night.
Say what, Tom? I didn't know you did that. That's awesome.
Oh yeah, he's the man. He's going to be going up next on the water. His name is Tom the Potter. He's riding for Lee Stone Products, Baraka, and Airtime Products. And, yep, that is going to be it.
Love the paint job on the boat as well.
Oh, yeah.
Bright gold. I like that with the red and black trim around it. Again, Tom Le- and you're saying Tom the Potter or Tom LePooter? Tom the Potter? Okay, got it. Awesome.
Tom Potter. There's a poodle, but it's a dog. That's a different competitor. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and all eyes on the water for your next competitor coming to you all the way from Brussels, Belgium, riding for Lee Stone Products, Let Baraka Nightclub, Airtime Products. His name is Tom the Potter, and he's taking over the Lake Havasu's water right now. Whenever he's ready, he's going to start his first trick. That's when we're going to start a countdown of about 60 seconds. Once again, we are not doing 1 minute routine, we're doing 60 seconds today. It's a little bit different from the 1 minute routine. Here we go. Goes for a huge aerial barrel into another 360 to the left. And it looks like a cool little throw right there.
Well, I'm not sure what happened on that.
Me neither, but let's see, maybe we can see a little bit more of that. Another wing set up for Tom the Potter. Backflip, one footer, going big, that's for sure. Tom the Potter right now, riding that revolver, manufactured by Lee Stone Products. Here we go. One hand 360 into a flyflip 360, another 360 into a backflip right now. Cool little combo right there for Tom the Potter. Check this out on that Lee Stone manufactured powered revolver hole. no hand 360 lander. Look at that 360 no hand to lander. What do you think about that? He grabbed those balls. You know what? I'm gonna do some more. We're gonna guess right back. If you don't see that often, nicely done. They call that trick either ghost rider backflip or fruit loop. The first guy who ever did it is actually Eric Malone.
Awesome.
Nicely done. Tell the party, ladies and gentlemen, your eight competitors in a pro freestyle at round one of 2015 IGSB Pro Freestyle Competition.
Put your hands together for him again, Tom LaPotter, the young rider out of Belgium who also sides as a DJ. I think we're going to steal him away and get him up in the tower tomorrow.
Oh, that's a good idea. And in meanwhile, I do have a score for Jonathan Covener. And the score is 45-28. So that will put him in the second place right now. So our top three are going to be Rashid Alola, Jonathan Covener, and after that, Chris Lightless. Chris Lightless in the third. In the second, Jonathan Kemener with 45.28 and Rashid Amoura with 45.45 in the first place. Okay, so we're going to gather the point for Tom LaPotter. And let me say something, a little something about our next competitor. He's coming all the way from Oakland, California. All the way. It's a big drive, don't get me wrong.
Not like Belgium, though.
But not like Belgium, that's for sure. He's coming all the way from Oakland, California. He's riding for Hurricane Industries, Fun Freestyle, imagine that, and the Ski Clinic. So, and his name is Ilaya Kamnitz, your last year amateur world champion, Eli Kamnitz. That guy is a monster. He loves to go big.
So, hi, Eli. You can tell he's getting ready.
He's getting ready. Let the judges give away their scores already. So they are focused on the water right now. So I believe if the Boat Freestyle is one of the sponsors, he is actually using his motor. Because he's definitely riding on a hurricane. I can see that. But inside is most probably going to be Fun Motor.
Awesome. All right, again, Fun Freestyle is sponsors, Hurricane Industries, and the Ski Clinic, what Iceman is referring to. And you are watching Eli Kamnitz. If that name sounds familiar, that is the name of some royalty. And I will tell you more about that in a minute as he gets ready.
Didn't like the first wake setup though. It doesn't count. Shouldn't count because he didn't went for the flip. He didn't went for anything. It shouldn't count. Just making sure that judges, yeah, it doesn't count. So you can still do that. You can drive through the wake. As long as you don't commit to that trick, it's not going to count.
So what Iceman's referring to is they determine when their routine starts, when they kick off their first trick, just like that.
Backflip right there. Huge backflip. Now we started that trick count, ladies and gentlemen. Now it looks like a no-wake backflip. So not a no-wake backflip. You can tell that he's a former racer, right? He goes fast into those rotations, that's for sure.
Doesn't mess around.
Kamnitz. Look at that. Eli Kamnitz. Right in for a Hurricane Industry Trump Freestyle and a Ski Clinic. Check this out. Now the wake setup goes for a 450 into a 360. Looks like he got stuck his feet in a foothold. But climbing back, truth to be said, he is actually right now riding with his wrist broken. His wrist is broken. Not many people know that. It should not matter as far as for the judges. So judges, don't pay attention to it. Nice backflip into a 360 to the left, now to the right, going into a submarine. Bringing the old school with the new school. What do you think about that? That's Eli Kamnitz. As I mentioned, he's riding injured right now and still decides to go for it, you know?
I love the merge of those two different styles, and vastly different styles that you're talking about. The old school, where it's a lot of flat water, that old school. And then you have, obviously, the new school, which is a lot of amplitude, a lot of combinations.
So once again, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Eli Kamnitz and his run at the round one of 2015 Pro Freestyle World Finals competition.
You know what? I got to do it because this awesome gentleman just happens to be up here in the tower. So I'm going to put him on the spot for a second, Iceman. And I tell you what, you were here when we first kicked off and started doing freestyle. I'm here with Larry Rippin Kroger. And what do you think of some of the things that we've had going on out on the water today?
It's unbelievable. I wish I'd have had that kind of horsepower back in the day.
Did you guys run with back then?
You know, modified 440s, 550s, stock hulls, you know, anything you could find to hold on back then.
So it's definitely a little bit envious, right, when you're like, oh my gosh, I like that whole bunch of that 900.
Oh yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Larry Rippin Kroger, thank you so much for hanging out with us.
Thank you, Don.
You're awesome.
Hashtag legend.
That was just one of your first ones. How many man crushes have you had?
All right, I believe we have an ex competitor on the water right now, coming all the way from the UK. His name is Jason Fleasdale, ladies and gentlemen, right for Extreme.
Yeah, it's actually X-Cream and Hartlepool Marina. Yep, and also from Trackstep. That is his sponsors for Jason Bleasdale.
Exactly. He is a British freestyle champion. I know that about him. And you know what? Him and his wife, Kim, they were actually organizing British Freestyle Championship this season. So, you know, he's not only on the water, but also behind the scenes. Very active. Look at that. 450 into a can-can backflip, into one-footed backflip. Check this out. Look at that. That's a way to open your routine. Now, that is something that we didn't see yet. Jason Fleasdale definitely loving his style right there. Loving the matching suit as well. 360 into a backflip. Nicely done.
I love the power underneath the hood. That boat is definitely wired pretty tight.
Oh, yeah, definitely. It has an X on its side. It's X-Cream power. What do you think about that? One-hand aerial barrel roll into one-foot backflip. Look at that little combo right there. Nice, but down Jason Fleasdale. Now 15 seconds to go. 15 seconds. Time for one more trick or a combination. Let's see what it's going to be. Look at that. Can-can one-hand backflip.
Wow.
Or Madonna backflip right there.
So that could be a Madonna or a can-can. All right, we're more than halfway through the field. That's gratuitous for you. Let's make it 2-for-1. Oh, okay, let's do 3. 360 and another backflip. 4 backflips and a 360 combination. Ladies and gentlemen, that was for you. He knew he wasn't on the clock. He just wanted to do something nice to make you guys happy. How you liking freestyle so far? And the crowd goes wild. I think you guys need some more free stuff. I'm just saying. So I'm going to give you Jay. No, I'm just kidding. What? Yeah, we're going to give a couple of Westside Power Sports shirts out for you. That's your one-stop shop for all Sea-Doo jet ski and jet boat parts. They're supporting our riders, supporting friends in the industry, like the Militian, Blosion, Jet Renew, and Jet Lift. We live, we breathe, and support the sport. WestsidePowerSports.com. See dealer for details with the first credit. Stock number 23425. Okay, I might have lied about that last part.
That's what's happening. Let me give you a score for Eli Chemnitz. Meanwhile, we have a score for Eli Chemnitz, which is 39.7. So Eli scores in 39.7. I believe we still have our same top three. In the first place is going to be Rashid Almoula. In the second place, if I'm not mistaken, is going to be Jonathan Kavanagh. And the third place is still going to be Chris Langley.
Yeah, it's actually Chris Langley that you are talking about. He's still in third?
He's still in third.
Oh, that's awesome.
Still there on the amateur boat.
Okay, and Jonathan Kavanagh, whose first time was over here, is second. And Rashid Almoula, you have not moved. You are still in the lead for Pro Freestyle Open.
We all gathered a point for Jason Bleasdale. But meanwhile, from the water, look at that. That's Christopher Anizeski coming all the way from Delroy Beach, Florida, riding for Odessa, Lee Stone Products, and Freestyle Connection, which is actually his own company.
Yes, it is. And I'll tell you something. It's Chris Anizeski, but what we like to do as a nickname is Chris Anizeski. Since his name's just a little bit hard to pronounce.
So it's not Chris
Anizeski? Yeah, Chris Anizeski instead of Chris Anizeski. Right. Although Rob Greenwald thinks we ought to be calling him Schwarzenegger because he's definitely been pumping a little iron this year. Guy looks amazing.
Right on. Looks like he's getting ready for his first weight setup. Here we go. What is it going to be? No hand. 360
into
backflip, definitely nice little combo to open your routine. What do you think about that?
Yeah, he's actually a great nutrition coach and workout coach as well, just something he does on the side.
That is very true, and let me go back to his equipment. He's fighting Lee Stone Products Revolver R Holness, and that you, well, there's only a couple of them out there. Huge one good backflip. Into a 360, look at that, they like the sound of that.
I think
he's going to be in the foothold of that revolver, but getting back to his wake setup, getting back into the shallow area right in front of the crowd right there, and his fellow competitors, last 15 seconds to go for Chris. One hand, one good back, but that would be 50-50, look at that. Still not happy with it, still going for it though. No wing backflip into another backflip. Number 3, 4, 5. Look at that, Chris Anizeski.
That's awesome. All right, again, that's a. Guy is actually on one of the RRP new boats that Iceman was talking to you about. This is Scratch that idea.
He is what he was supposed to be.
Yeah.
He is right now on his own Lee Stone Products Revolver R Hole powered by Jetta. And of course, he is going to be most probably on it tonight. I mean, the big. Don't forget, guys, that tonight, 6 o'clock, Pro Motion Expression Session Round 2 of 2015 Pro Freestyle IGNC World Finals Competition is going to happen. It's going to be 2 minutes. You know, it's going to be dark. Those guys are going to trick out their skis. They're going to put some LEDs on their skis. Some of them. It's going to be fun. It's going to be like a Christmas tonight.
Yeah, it certainly is. Hey, you guys, are y'all having a good time? I was just checking because I tell you what, you've been out here in the hot sun, and while we're doing this freestyle, I just want to give you a little warm love. Here we go. Got some koozies for you. Thank you to Villain Clothing, who, by the way, is down in Vendor Alley. So again, Villain Clothing down in Vendor Alley. I had to walk down because I can't turn my car. It's really good, bro. I just throw like me, which is nothing but.
Very well. And meanwhile, I do have a score for Jason Gleesdale. Jason Gleesdale's score is 43.5. So, ladies and gentlemen, right now, Jason Gleesdale's score is 43.5, if you keep in track. And then we still have our top three the same. Rashid Almula. After that, we do have Jonathan Kemener in the second spot right now, and Chris Line is still in the third.
All right, so top three haven't changed after that last set of scores. Again, you've got Chris Ling Lane, Jonathan Kemener on second, and Rashid Almula from Dubai, sponsored by Skydive Dubai, in the lead right here at the Pro Freestyle Open 2015 Quick Descent World Final.
Oh, yeah. But you know what? All that can change. It can change tonight, it can change tomorrow. Because after tonight, the only top 10 are going to go back here.
Yeah.
And on the lunchtime, there's going to be only 10 athletes on the water. Only 10 top 10 athletes are going to be allowed to for tomorrow's finale. And we'll see how that's going to work tomorrow.
So can you explain that score system to me? So what they're going for today is, oh, we're not sure. Okay. We'll let you know.
I just want to show a few people that this is not a qualifying. This counts
right.
With tonight, for sure, 100%. So how is that going to affect? tomorrow?
Yes.
If we're going to drop the scores?
Yes.
We're going to find out for you.
The next gentleman who's taking over the water is... That is going to be the gentleman out of Clearwater, Florida. He's sponsored by X-Cream, BP, Barack, Graphics, and Power Factor. And that is going to be the Destroyer, Chase Destroyer.
Jason Stoyer taking over the water. Look at that.
Amateur world champion, multiple national champion. Has been on TV several different times.
Oh, yeah.
Was on that. Was on Inc., wasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, remember that one time he got missing? He was on TV that he was missing?
True.
Oh, he already saw it. Look at that. Look at the one-hander, 360. Into cool flat spin 360. Into backflip, down a backflip. Check this out. To be fair, the first one was more of a barrel rolling streak.
Okay.
It's hard to tell, especially from that angle. But let's say it was barrel rolling streak 60. Now to mix it up for Jason Stoyer. Look at that one-hander lazy backflip. Check this out. Definitely bringing it one of his own style into the routine. We'd love to see that. Judges love to see that. Look at that power 360 one-hander. Bringing it old school, the new school. Look at the slide in the one for the 360. Check this out, holding on to that powerful machine built by D-Max Screen. Look at that huge logo on the side. Yard to miss. Last 15 seconds for Jason. Destroyer, Destroyer. Look at that. Huge, lazy forward flip. 540. Look at that. A one hitter. Righty. Look at that. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you think about that? Definitely not imitated by
Dino.
What do you think about that?
I loved it. I always love Jason's routines. He brings so much fun and attitude to it. He's definitely a showman. Ladies and gentlemen, do it one more time for me. Put your hands together for Jason Stoyer.
Nicely done. Nicely done. And I do have a
scoreboard
here. Meanwhile, I do have a score for Chris Kenny Zeski, which is going to be 43.84, which is going to put him on a third place right now. So our top three right now changes because we do have Rashid Amula in the first, Jonathan Cavanaugh in the second, but Christopher Anizeski in the third with 43.84.
All right, one more time. In third place, Chris Anizeski, who just moved into that third place position, Jonathan Cavanaugh in second, and Rashid Amula still holding on to that lead. You can see him down there reacting to it. We still have a lot of competitors left, though. You were watching Pro Freestyle. I like this so much.
Oh, yeah. We do have a four guys to go through. This one is going to be Derek Kennedy Jr. Then we have somebody who's going to mispronounce his name. That's for sure. Because he's from Japan. There's no way I can get this right.
I can do it.
You can do it? You speak Japanese?
No, but I know people.
Oh, cool.
I know people I can ask, is what I'm telling you.
Well, that's why I added you on Facebook, you know?
Yeah. Iceman, you're awesome. Oh, my gosh. You guys, by the way, we're very lucky to have Iceman up here, Bollock, and he has done this fantastic tour, and I'm just going to crack you up on that. Did this great European tour, bringing it over to the United States for 2016. So a huge announcement for him. I really appreciate all your hard work.
Definitely. I'd like to say that it's been a while. You know, we wanted to, you know, come with the tour, which has been very successful. It's a freestyle-only tour. It's hashtag no racing, hashtag... You know, it's hashtag freestyle only. We're trying to build the freestyle community. We feel like it needs it. And we went with the riders 300%, you know, as far as the goal of the sport. You know, we started with 8 riders. Now we have almost 30. It's unbelievable. It's great. And next year, we're going to bring the tour here, going to West Coast, East Coast rounds, you know, start slow. You need to crawl before you walk and walk before you run. So we're going to crawl next year, start here in Havasu in April, and going to go to Florida. Mike Duncan is actually scouting out, you know, lake for us.
Aww.
I told him I need a freshwater lake with no gators.
Right? With no gators. Oh, my gosh, that's awesome.
So,
all right.
Yeah.
Again, shout and props for Iceman. I keep tuned to that. You can friend him on Facebook. I've also got a website, I do believe, don't you?
Oh, yeah. You know what social media are so strong nowadays? Hashtag PWC Freestyle USA. You're going to find us on the Twitter. You're going to find us on the Instagram, on the Facebook. Whatever is going to be hot tomorrow, we'll be on it. That's for sure. And also on a regular, interact. www.pwcfreestyleusa.com. But, ladies and gentlemen, your next competitor is on the water right now. It's Derek Kamen Jr. taking over the water, coming all the way from Oakley, California, riding for Speed Clinic, Hot Products, Hurricane Industries, HydroTurf. Look at that. Derek Kamen Jr. is taking over the water right now. He's your former amateur world champion, also your West Coast champion, West Coast freestyle champion. He is the one who is going to be taking over right now for 60 seconds. Whenever he's ready, now he's most probably going to try to warm up that motor, get in the zone, and whenever he is ready, he's going to start with that first trick. Whenever he hits for that first trick, we're going to start a countdown of 60 seconds, and it's going to be about right now. Look at that. Huge one hand, 1 foot 360 into another 1 foot 360 into 180, 1 footer backflip into 360 into 1 footer backflip into another 1 footer backflip. Look at that, aim is added. Now, David Jr. Nice 360 into another 360 into another 360. Landing hard on the side right there, but holding on to that powerful speed, which he actually builds himself, because you know what? He is the CEO of Hurricane Industries. He is the man to talk to as far as those magnificent goals. Look at that huge 360 into 450, into a 360, and another 360, and another 360, now into 180, another 360, and into backflip, and another backflip. Last 15 seconds, he's going at it, that's for sure. This is Derek Kamen Jr., ladies and gentlemen. Look at that, another wing setup. Let's see if he can squeeze it in. I'm not quite sure. Unfortunately, this one is just for you guys. This one's not going to count. No handle error, you. 360, no handle error. What do you think about that? Ladies and gentlemen, that was Derek Kamen Jr. out of Oakley, California, riding for Ski Clinic, Hot Products, Hurricane Industries, and HydroTurf. And meanwhile, we actually do have a score for Jason Sawyer. So if you are keeping up with those numbers, the magic number for Jason Sawyer is 43.22 for Jason Sawyer. I believe that would still keep. Oh yeah, we still have same top three riders on the top. That means Rashid Abdullah in first, Jason, Jonathan Kamener in the second, and of course Christopher Anizeski in the third. So these would be your top three riders as of right now. And our next competitor. With a difficult Japanese
name. Oh, you want me to do that? Okay. He's out of Osaka, Japan. He is sponsored by Koiki Scent. His name, Naoya Hamanaka.
There you go. Okay.
I was pretty good on that, wasn't I?
Right on. Well, wait. I'm still working on my Japanese, The only thing I can say Japanese is Toyota and Honda.
And Ichiba.
Oh, yeah, there's that. That's how you order a sushi, right?
No.
No?
Konnichiwa is a greeting.
Oh, okay, like good morning.
Mm-hmm.
Or good day? Is it good morning?
You know more than you think. You're just all here picking out.
That's why I have you on my Facebook.
I'll tell you something else. I know how to say good morning or good afternoon and how is everybody in Polish. Would you like me to do that for you? Okay, hold on.
It's Dzień dobry, actually. I'm originally from Prague, Czech Republic, which is not that far from Poland, so, plus, both languages are Slavic, so
there
it's
you
very
go.
Similar.
Oh, that's right, because you're kind of from that area.
So I partially speak Slavic.
Okay, I tell you what, hold on one second, Iceman, because we were speaking Polish and we spoke a little Japanese, but now I think we're going to speak a little Yamaha. If you want a Yamaha t-shirt?
Yamaha!
If you want a Yamaha t-shirt, say it really loud back at me. Yamaha! Who can say it loudest? Wow, that one was good. That one was good. Good job, guys.
Your Japanese is getting so much better. Japanese. Oh, my. Yamaha. Right on.
That was awesome.
Okay, so I think we get it all the points.
Man, who had that softball? Was that Watkins that threw that out of the tower?
Yeah, we.
Man, you're like a legend.
We actually get it all the points, and we are ready for our next competitor, which is going to be
Naoya Hamanaka.
Naoya
Hamanaka.
Naoya Hamanaka.
Sponsored by Quakey Sense.
Oh, yeah.
I tell you what, no matter how you pronounce his name, I watch this guy in practice. He goes big. So I can't wait to see his routine.
Oh, yes. That's for sure. And he is the stranger for World Championships. To World Finals actually over here. That's where he pointed. That's where I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go there. I'm gonna go up. I'm gonna go up.
I know he's actually pointing the direction.
Very well. So, ladies and gentlemen, all eyes on the water right now for Naoya Yamahaka. Who is actually riding on a Listo Products revolver? Let me tell you that. I don't know what motor is he running in, but it's definitely powerful. Look at that huge one through the backflip. Oh, into another backflip. Into another backflip. Into a 360 to the left. Another 360 to the left. Another 360 to the left. Another 360. Look at that.
Wow.
No way 360. Nope, not a 360. Check this out. This is Naoya Hamanaka, all the way from Japan, competing at the round one of 2015 IGSB World Championship. Look at that flat spin 360. Another one hand 360, another 360, and another 360. Another 360, another 360, another 360. Look at that. He's going around and round and round in circles.
That is awesome.
Last 15 seconds, time for one more trick or a combo. I guess it's going to be combo. Look at 450, 540. Now, no wake aerial barrel. What do you think about that?
I love it. I love that he's reversing.
No wake 360, one handle lander. Nice and done. That 540 was pretty cool, actually.
I have to say, that was pretty awesome. Naoya Hamanaka from Osaka, Japan. Ladies, don't put your hands together for him.
Very well done. You know, I think he wanted to go for a 360. Then he was like, you know what, we need to focus you on the beach. I might as well go through 540.
I love the amplitude on that opening trick as well. That was gratuitous right there, wasn't it?
And he was just repeating that for you guys. One through the backflip, great amplitude on that. Nicely done. This was Naoya Yamahaka. 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 There you go, Hamanaka. Naoya Hamanaka. Okay, that's it. Naoya Hamanaka. That's what's
did
up.
You actually doubt me, Iceman?
Right on. Okay, and you know what? I do have a score for Derek Kimmett Jr. right here in front of me. Ladies and gentlemen, and you know what? We do have a new third place because that is exactly where it's going to put him with his score of 44.22 in the third place. Now we do have Derek Kemmett Jr. with a 44.22 in the second, still Jonathan Kavanagh, and in the first, of course, all the way from Dubai, Rashid Al-Mullah. Very well. While we're going to be waiting on to get the scores for Naoya Hamanaka. I'm getting good at it, that's for sure. The next competitor. Final two competitors, actually, just to give you a heads up. next competitor is coming to you all the way from Austin, Texas, and he rides for Team X Green, Austin Jetskier Lakeside Marine and Power Factor. His name is Chase Forrest, and he is also one of your freestyle amateur champions. He really wants to go on that water. And just to tell you, just to let the Coast Guard officials know, he actually is wearing a life vest underneath that t-shirt.
I actually was going to point that out as well. Yeah, that's a signature thing for Jace. He likes to have the t-shirt on over it representing for his sponsors, but he does actually have a life jacket underneath that, just so you guys know. We wouldn't let him out in the water, otherwise.
Exactly. So definitely keep your eyes on the water. We are gathering the points for...
Simon says we need to get it on a little bit faster, but we can. We got to make sure that we're getting the right scores. But a special thanks, by the way, to Simon Ricks, who is slowly melting down there.
I believe we are ready. We are ready.
That's right.
The judges gave their points for Naoya Hamanaka. Just need to say it, man. Just need to say math, and it's going to sound Japanese. Even if I say Chase Forrest, it's going to sound Japanese, but partially. You laugh. Are you laughing at me or at me?
I actually love the rip part today. I thought that was really good. Okay, but anyway,
our next competitor is coming to you all the way from Austin, Texas, and his name is Chase Forrest. So Chase, whenever you're ready, the water is yours. Whenever you're ready, the water is yours. His sponsors.
I got him. Team X Cream. Also, he is sponsored by Austin Jet Skier, Lakeside Marine, and Power Factor. Ladies and gentlemen, put it together for Chase Forrest.
Chase Forrest. He was on the right ski last year, I remember. Remember how he could hit those blue LEDs on his boat?
Yeah.
I hope he's going to do that for tonight. And look at that. We were just talking about that pink is you black.
You know, yes, you did.
The pink is you black. And look at his gloves. Look at his gloves. You know, he's rocking that pink. That's Chase Forrest on the water. Ladies and gentlemen, your next competitor in at the round one of 2015 Pro Freestyle IGNP World Finals Freestyle Competition. So whenever he's going to warm up that powerful motor, and get his mindset right, he is gonna come back, gonna make that first wake set up, and the second he's gonna start that first trick, we're gonna start a countdown of 60 seconds. Again, not 1 minute, 60 seconds. That's it. Are you sure?
Yeah, 1 minute is 60 seconds.
Here we go! Huge 415! No hander into a nose grabber backflip. Into 360, into another backflip, into another 360, another 360, into backflip. Look at that!
Yeah, but nobody else was catching it. That's why I was saying it. All right, gorgeous routine so far for Chase Forrest.
No way, 360, into another 360, into another 360, going around a circle, another 360. Into a backflip right now. Check this out. What do you think about that? Nice. Now that is smooth, right?
I was very impressed with this guy.
Gosh, look at that. He's smooth as butter. That's for sure. I like his style.
Another rider sponsored by X-Cream.
Last 15 seconds. Huge nose grabber backflip into a 450. Into a backflip. A rail grabber right there. Check this out.
How about it? Woo!
Nicely done. And this is it, ladies and gentlemen. This one's just for you. Look at that. He went for a 750, let me tell you. Yeah, he was facing back. Unfortunately, it was only 540, but still pretty impressive.
Woo-hoo! Put your hands together one more time for Jake Forrest.
Perfect. Now, that was cool. You know, look at that. He's rocking those pink gloves. You know, pink is the new black. That's for sure. And you know what? We do have a score for our previous rider. Naoya Hamanaka.
I don't know if that was...
That was correct.
Oh, he's giving you a thumbs up on it.
Or maybe it was his sister's name. I'm not sure about that. But anyway, it still makes him our new leader, though, because his score is 46.4, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, you guys, one more time. Put your hands together for this gentleman. Naoya Hamanaka just moved into the lead, sponsored by Quickie Sense with a 46.1. What does that do to the rest of this here?
In the second, in a silver spot right now, is Rashid Alkula. In the third right now, we have Jonathan Kavanagh. Jonathan Kavanagh in the third, Rashid Almua in the second, and our previous competitor, Naoya Hamanaka, first.
I think he just likes the fact that he got so much attitude with it.
Okay, so we got to get it a point for Chase Burton.
One more time, I think somebody just asked down there. Naoya Hamanaka is your new leader. And in second place is Rashid Almola. He is in second. And in third, Jonathan Kavanagh. That's your rundown. Right now, though. Okay, that's just right now. We still have more to come.
Exactly. That is just right now. And there's going to be tonight. So don't forget, guys. It's not going to be that hot because the sun is going to be down already.
Was that like the 1 minute, 60 seconds?
Duh. We will stage the ride at 6 o'clock tonight, and the show will start at 6:45. So bring your chairs. It's going to be a lot of fun, that's for sure.
All right, you guys, one more time. I just want to remind you what he was just saying. So, riders, listen up. We are going to stage you at 6 o'clock down at the Kokomo's area, okay? So we're going to be doing the night show. We are staging at 6 p.m. And then we're going to get rocking at 6:45. Again, 6 p.m. need you down at staging. Okay, Iceman, back to you. Alright, you guys, we have one more competitor to go. He comes from the United Kingdom. Guys want some more stuff from Yamaha, I know you. He is sponsored by Team Xcream, Airtime Products, Full Spectrum, and HydroTurf, and he is just about to make his way out to the water. He is also your last year's world champion, and he is also a multiple world champion. He is also the guy that first did the backflip in the Kokomo's pool, which is almost as famous as all the other stuff. Put your hands together for Lee Stone.
Very well. So, defending world champion is going to be on the water next, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see if he's going to, you know, play it safe and, you know, not show us everything.
Oh, I'm sure. But he's only got, you know, 1 minute, not 60 seconds. Oh, I reversed it, didn't I?
Duh. Hashtag duh.
Hashtag duh.
He's taking over the water right now. Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure that you are watching this guy very closely because he is very fast. As far as his rotation, unbelievable. He goes big, he likes it, and as you can see, he's a crowd pleaser himself. World champion, British champion, also European champion, Mr. Lee Stone himself, CEO of Lee Stone Products. He is, his company is manufacturing these boats. He is actually competing on. So if you like what you see, if you get your kids or girlfriends, boyfriends into the sport, make sure you're going to get in touch with these guys. You know, they definitely can boot you up, that's for sure. So next in the water, your final competitor, as of right now, Lee Stone, he's going for his first wake set up. And here we go, it's going to be big. Huge 540 into a one hand. One foot backflip into 360, into one foot backflip into a 360, one foot backflip, another 540 into 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 backflip, another 140 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 into backflip
I know, I was just trying to watch you do the call on that, and you actually ran out of breath before he ran out of tricks. Unbelievable for this one-minute routine from Lee Stone.
There's more. Look at that. Look at
that. The Trick Licker. Oh, unbelievable. Woo-hoo! Which, by the way, was an innovation that he developed, the Hill Clicker, that was a backflip Hill Clicker, and that is what took him right to the top last year as well.
Right on.
Unbelievable routine for Lee Stone. Congratulations. Wow, that was so much fun to watch.
That is unbelievable. I really wish you'd have the scores for Chase Forrest. Chase Forrest's scores would be 45. Chase Forrest, and his score is 45-00. I believe that would be fourth position for Chase Forrest. Fourth position as of right now. We still don't have the scores for Lee Stone, your final competitor.
Gotcha.
So as of right now, Chase Forrest, number four.
I'm just guessing, but that might have. That might have taken him to the top, but it's hard to say. I don't want to say anything. All right, Riders. One quick thing on the scoring, just so we can explain that to you really quick. We are going on a straight scoring system. Oh my gosh, I just dropped a pin on that poor lady.
You just dropped a pin.
I got so excited about the scoring. Thank you. All right, so we are going to go to a scoring system, and the scoring system is based through how you scored as far as your placement. So if you got first or second, there's a point score that goes with that. So if you got a first, you get 10 points. That's how they're going to score. They're going to combine today and tonight. And then once those combined scores are together, they will take the top 10. And that is going to be who you are going to be watching tomorrow for the finals for Pro Freestyle. You're going to want to be right back here. Don't forget to go to Vendor Alley. Iceman, back to you.
Oh, definitely. We still are.
Well, actually, I heard the background. I think we have a new leader.
I heard it. I just don't know the scores, but I think it's fair to say for us that.
I think so.
Your top three competitors as of right now are Mr. Lee Stone, number one. That is for sure. In that's second, we would have
Naoya Hamanaka.
Of course, there will be Naoya Hamanaka in a second. And that would put Rashid Almola in third. That will be your top three riders as of right now.
That is correct. Again, Rashid Almola, you are in third. Great job today. And in second place is going to be Naoya Hamanaka. Don't forget to join us again, 6 o'clock tonight. We're going to be having the staging for the riders. We will get you those final scores in just a second. We got chastised because we had premature acceleration up here. So we got a red flag on us, too. Doggone it. I'll let Iceman give you the final scores.
Official, unofficial. Let me go from the back.
Okay.
In the 16th position, we have Elijah Chemnitz. In the 15th, Tom DePutter. In the 14th, we do have Mark Gomez. In 13th, we do have Jason Sawyer. And I believe in 12th, in 11th, standing by, okay. Okay, once again, official, unofficial scores. Obviously, for official ones, you would need to check the pit board or the beach house or the beautiful blonde lady named Caroline. She's running around and riding on the bicycle around the pit. So you would need to do that.
Caroline Justina, I think is who you are referring to. Yes.
Well,
she can help you out as well, but do check your pit boards for your final scores today for freestyle. Thank you.
Okay, so let me do that one more time from the 16th place, Elijah Chemnitz. Number 15, Tom the Potter. Number 14, Mark Gomez. Number 13, Jason Stoyer. Number 12, Jason Wittes. Number 11, Jason Bleasdale. Number 10, Taji Yamamoto. Number 9, Tanner Thomas. Number 8 is Chris Lilas. Number 7 is Chris Anizeski. Number 6 is Derek Kimnitz Jr. Number 5 is Jace Forrest. Number 4, Jonathan Kevener. Number 3, Rashid Almula. Number 2, Naoya Yamanaka. And number 1, of course, is the Lee Stone. So this is your standing as of right now. So I'll leave it back to you, and I'll see you at 6:45 on the London Bridge.
Iceman, thank you. You are just the best, my friend. Really appreciate all your help. I know that takes that time out of your awesome day on your vacation, but we very much appreciate you coming up and hanging out with us. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our guest announcer for Freestyle, Iceman.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I do appreciate it.
You're awesome, buddy. Okay, we will see all of you guys back out tonight, too, for more Freestyle. Do not forget that Expression Session is going to be starting tonight. For your purposes, if you're going to come hang out with us, be there by no later than 6:45 or 7 o'clock. We're about to get ready to go, and we're going to be doing a great demonstration out on the water right now. We got all kinds of water toys coming at you. You can find out more about these water toys at Aqualife, the Aqualife area, but just got a demonstration going on. And just some of the other great ways you can experience the water. On behalf of myself, Don Dawson, Mike Young, and Jersey J, we'll be right back. I just wanted to turn the mic over to Tommy Duddle, who is actually going to be telling us a little bit about more of these awesome water toys. Tommy, thank you, buddy.
All right, what you're watching out here is the Sea Breacher and the Jetivator. And the Sea Breacher right there is like a submarine. And this is built on a Sea-Doo 260. And it's custom built by Rob Ennis, made in California. And you can get it custom made exactly how you want it. You can get the killer whale, you can get the shark. There's all different designs. Looking at submarine coming up out of the water right there. And then again, you got the Jetivator. Jetivator powered by the water that the Sea-Doo 260 right there powers through the hose. You can use that even with the Yamaha watercraft. And the backflip right there spins it around, makes it look easy. Again, these are made right in California, the Sea-Doo, the Sea Breacher, and the Jetivator. And the Sea Breacher right there, you see them spinning all the way around, 360, being able to above the water, underwater. The controls are very much like a plane. So if you were in a plane and you watched how they had their hand controls and their feet controls, that's similar with the Sea Breacher. Very easy to operate. Two riders inside of it. Got a double harnessing system that locks everybody in place. You can see this one kind of ride down its side right here. You can see the snorkel up on top that allows the air to get down into the motor. And again, you can see right here, this is Rob on the Sea Breacher right there, lifting it up. So you got Rob Ennis, the owner of Sea Breacher and Jetivator, one of the drivers of that Sea Breacher, and Joe Natale. And Kirk Bittner right there, he's on the Jetivator with the EKM, the driverless jet ski. He's controlling all the driving right there. You can see on the other watercraft, a lot of people have been asking all weekend how the rider on the watercraft controls the person on the hydroflight device. These hydroflight devices are actually called the Jetivator. Coming up through with You can see right here, this is Rob Ennis right here, the owner right here, giving you the peace sign. He pulled open the cockpit. And want to thank everybody. Want to check out Sea Breach and Jetivator more closely. You can see their booth is right at the front, the entrance. We'd like to thank everybody for watching.
afternoon. How's everybody doing out there? Okay, is anybody hot? Is anybody out there hot? It's hot up in here, man. I'm sweating like Mike Tyson in a spelling bee, bro. It's ridiculous. But I got something that can cool you off, and that's a free t-shirt. How's that, huh? How about some free t-shirts out there? Yeah! Lake Havasu, wake up! Where are you guys at? Try that again. There we go. I ain't no Jameis Winston. I'm an Aaron Rodgers. By the way, there we go, guys. You guys having fun down there? I'm trying to get one down to you guys down there, too. There we go. Sorry about that. Who needs a hood seal? There we go. Everybody's a winner. WatchOn.com in the house, baby. Yeah. Who's going extreme with jet ski? The new experience. The world's number one professional jet ski tournament. Who wants a free video? Oh, little guy wants a video? Oh, we'll hook him up right there. Watch it. What else we got here to give away? I'm going to give away Dawn Dolphins, ladies and gentlemen. Dawn, you're coming over the tower.
Incoming. He wouldn't give me away. Would you give me away?
I gave you away. You know why?
Why?
I should probably explain that, but I'm not gonna. Hey, by the way, I like your Divas bling on your staff shirt there, but let's talk a little bit about the new brand from Quakey Sense,
Kuta. Kuta is actually a brand new line from Quakey Sense. It is so cool that they came up with this innovation.
How cool is it?
Well, thank you for the lead-in. I appreciate it.
Thanks for that segue, Mike Young.
And down here on the showroom floor. So Kuta is actually a brand new line of wetsuits, but they developed a line of wetsuits for kids, but like for winter kids. And they're so cool. Yeah. So you guys gotta check that out. And then, you know, if you like to dress the same as your kids.
Exactly.
Personally, I don't know that I would do that, but if you want to, you can. They've got the adult wear also in the same cool colors this year. Or if you don't have kids, but you would just like the really cool adult wear. There you go.
Hey, by the way, I'd like to say a very special thanks to Rubber Distributing for sponsoring the lunch break.
And the breakfast brunch. And I'm guessing the after a pre-party. All right, you guys, we've got the juniors coming down, and I need to run down to the line.
Juniors.
I actually need to run down to the line because I've got a presentation for the juniors, and I'm going to go do that right now.
We don't have our sheets yet, but as soon as we do have our sheets up here on the announcing tower, we will run through the junior lineup for everybody. Hope everybody's having a great day down there.
Actually, we do have sheets. You're not sheetless. Well, they were.
You got to be sheeting me.
All by my sheet. Here we go.
Dawn, please give up the karaoke.
Nope, not going to happen.
All right, yeah, I guess we do got sheets up here now. Let's find a clipboard for them.
Hey, Micah, are those the juniors down on the line right now?
I believe they are the juniors down on the line right now. This is the junior ski 13 to 15 limited class, ladies and gentlemen. Limited class, we're talking about bolt-on performance. Something that you can see later tonight at Kokomo.
You're so goofy.
I know.
That's why we love you. Well, it's actually just one reason why we love you. So what we're going to do, by the way, guys, I know that you're about to go racing, and you got to focus. But come on, it's the juniors, and they like to have fun. And I want to make sure you guys have fun. So we are actually awarding, for no reason whatsoever other than we love you, every one of the juniors today is going to get some freaking underwear. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to hand it to the holders when you're done. And the holders are going to get to pick out the colors, so you might want to tell them right now what kind of colors you like.
Dawn, why do you always get to give away the underwear?
I know it. I'm always giving away the underwear. So the holders are going to make sure that everybody gets their own freaking underwear. Special thanks to Free Gun. We really appreciate you guys. Thank you so, so much for sponsoring the World Finals. Yeah, you very well. It's embarrassing, like you told me I didn't have to talk, and then you stick a mic right in front of me. All right, Mikey, back to you in the tower, but again, special thanks to Freegan.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I love Freegan too, man. They did a great job sponsoring the Jet Cross Tour over in Europe this year. And again, sponsoring watercraft racing, motocross racing, all Lake Action Sports. Special thanks to Freegan.
So, juniors, are you guys pretty excited about this? Everybody gets some Freegan under it? Seem pretty excited. Awesome. Be sure to say thanks to these guys for doing that for you, and we'll see you at the finish line.
All right, let's go through the lineup. Junior Speed 13-15, limited boat number 888. It's out behind the space. Come to us, Hannah Poland, riding for ProTech Motors, Dane Team Racing, and Quakey Sims, aware of photo number one, Casper Tania. He'll be joined by boat number 53, Martin Manny. Coming to us out of Estonia, riding for Quakey Sims and a miscourt. Tassabong Tunchathai will be on boat number 259. Out of Thailand, riding for 59 Racing. And out of Tumwater, Washington, riding for Blosian Jet Pilot HydroTurf, it's boat number 33, Carson Hughes. Boat number 142, come to us from Thailand, a privateer out there, Kaden Chertabeef. Boat number 4, out of Peoria, Illinois, riding for Commander Industries, LB1 Designs. Burn Industries and Rockstar, and that is Braden Wicklund. Boat number 7, out of Aljab, United Arab Emirates, riding for the NAS team, Salman Al-Mahdi. Boat number 10 is the Angry Bird, out of the United Kingdom, riding for OB Oils. It is Chloe Marsh. Boat number 53 on the Kawasaki is Holland Harry Robinson, also from the United Kingdom, riding for Mack Racing. And obviously, we had a little premature acceleration down there on the starting line. Boat number 212, Don Dawson, come on, don't make me laugh, is Deanna Wilson, 255, is Musselman. Mangoon, and boat number 139, Michelle Seedley. Boat number 9 is Davey Prado, and boat number 98 is Aaron Cantwell. We got anybody from the United Kingdom out there in the stands today? Come on, make some noise! Hey, hold on a second. Somebody needs to translate my American to their English, I guess. Because they're all sitting right over here. I know you guys aren't listening to me, are you? You guys are too busy talking. Yeah, I know. Well, it's happening, so you can do it. We'll allow it. I said, do we have anybody from Great Britain here? There we go. Now we're talking. Kuta by Quakey Sense. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to stop on down at the souvenir booth. The official booth is run by Shirtworks. Ronnie Bumgarner and the crew, man. They've got all the good stuff down there, and the blue light is always flashing. You know, you can always talk him into a special deal. Stop on down, say hello to Ronnie at Shirtworks. Hey, by the way, any of you guys right down here in the stands right here, any of you guys in the stands got any money I can borrow? I'll pay you back. I'll get you back next year. I'd gladly pay you Tuesday for $10 today. Sorry, I had no toys when I was little, man. They let me up here by myself, and this is what happens. All my rowdy friends are in the house here in Lake Havasu. Love to be here. There was a nasty rumor that I wasn't coming. But again, it was a nasty rumor, and that's all it was. If there ain't no way that I would ever miss coming out here to Lake Havasu and hanging out with about 5,000 of my dysfunctional friends. I'm sorry, maybe 5,002. Juniors, C13-15, limited poised to take off here. This is race number 14. For those of you folks that are listening in on the SurfRant.tv live stream, this is moto number 1 for these juniors out here. We've got 20 photos today. And don't forget to tune in tonight, man. Me and Surf Rat could be kicking it on the live stream. That tonight is going to be a party. By the way, we just want to let everybody know it is PG-13. I'm just saying, it is going to be a lot of fun tonight with Zograph. Underneath the London Bridge, we've got freestyles, expression sessions brought to you by DASA. Junior ski, 13 to 15, light class. Casper Kanya, once again, a winner of photo number one. Looks like we're going to go green. Yeah, you know what, the announcer cursed. Now I see red. I see red people out on the track, and that is not good. That means they're going to bring him back to the line. Repackery, stack, re-rack, or restart this one all over again. By the way, we'd like to give a big shout-out to Westside Powersports. Westside Powersports is your one-stop shop for all your Sea-Doo, jet ski, and jet boat parts. You know, they've been supporting riders for a long time, supporting friends in the industry like Liquid Militia, Pelosian, Jet Renew, and Jet Live. They live, breathe, and support the sport. Check them out online at westsidepowersports.com. Well, I'll tell you what, hopefully the third time will be the charm here for this junior ski limited class. We'll let you know who the fielding parties are as soon as we do up here on the announcing tower. Obviously, having to bring them back twice, see if we can't figure it out. Boat number 53 called for the jump there, Harry Robinson. So a tough break for Harry coming to us from the United Kingdom. That's all right. I like to see Harry pass people as he comes through the back anyway. Up next will be our GP runabout for those of you who may be listening in at all. GP runabout will be coming up next. You can join us immediately following racing as we head up the street on McCulloch Avenue, the little place called BJ's. After a little happy hour before we get to our expression session tonight, which is going to be underneath the London Bridge. So, boat number 33, starting with a dead engine. Is Carson Hughes. That's a tough break for Hughes, as Hughes had a fourth place in the first photo. Once again, this is the second photo for these guys. Casper Kanya, you'll kill this prince. Look out for him as he's on some borrowed property out there from Jerry Wong. Actually, I should probably say rented property. And it's going to be Kanya on the inside. Casper Kanya with your hole shot as he works left to right down the front straight away. Let's hear it for him, Lake Havasu. Okay, it looks like the T-59 back there in that second place position. That belongs to Tutatai. That is the T-59 at Tutatai with a third place in photo number one. We go a little bit further back in the pack here in just a couple of moments as they work their way around the log jumps. Again, the kids do not get the log jumps. Casper, Kanya, taming the waves here in Lake Havasu. Junior ski, 13 to 15 limited. You're on lap number one, and this is going to be a six-lap race, six laps to glory. By the way, I'd like to give a big shout out to, I was talking to Rhea Pope and Bill Pope. They got a bunch of folks that are listening in back home in Great Britain. They wanted to say hey to all their friends back there in Great Britain. My name's Mike, and I'm just a conduit. All you contractors know what I'm talking about. Your leader, Kanya, opting for the inside split. Still Tsujitai. Back there in that second place position, it's Tsujitai. We'll take the outside. Big battle for third place right now. We'll try to run down those numbers as they come back down our front straight away. Race number 15, GP Runabout, is coming up next. I'd like to say a very special thanks to our manufacturer members, Yamaha and Sea-Doo. You know, a lot of stuff going on back here in Performance Alley. I know that you folks listening at home don't want to know too much about Performance Alley, but we got to talk about it, man, because there is so much cool stuff that all the vendors have brought out in 2016. And my favorite booth back there is the Jumbo Corn Dog booth. How about yours, Ian?
No, burritos all week for me.
Burritos all week for Ian. Okay, I gotcha. Martin Manny in the third spot, followed by vote number 142. Beneath Therapy back there in the fourth spot. Going back to fifth, it looks like vote number four, Braden Whitwood. Once again, this is only the first photo here for our junior C, 13-15 limited class. And again, folks, listening in at home, don't forget, coming up next, with your seatbacks and tray table, with the upright block position, as we have got our GP runabout, man, and these guys were blistering fast this morning. Hey, by the way, I'd like to give a big shout out to the Silverstein clan that's in the house. Willie Silverstein, Johnny O. Silverstein, and Doug Silverstein, all here. That's right, Diane. Hey, by the way, congratulations to Diane. I heard she had a royal flush up here in Vegas before she came down. That's going to take your ass a trip. Yeah, Doug Silverstein, also known as Burt Wonderstone. Your leader, Casper Konya, Poland, is in the house, and he is representing Protec Motors. Konya trying to put a little real estate between me and second place. Mark Manning has advanced up into that second place position, and Suchitai drops back to third. Still Turner Finn in the fourth spot. Whitland in fifth. As we do it here from the Grady Sense Tower of Power. Look out, here comes that boat number seven. Man, that's a fast boat. We've seen that a little earlier today. That's Salman Almani. And Almani with a world title a little bit earlier this week. How's everybody doing? You guys doing all right out there? You having fun, man? It's a junior class. Yeah, just through our sports. It's all good. All good in our neighborhood. You got that right.
How you doing?
Get a fire. The blue flag comes out. That means there's a race going on and you're not in it. Move out the way. Here comes the 888. Casper Konya on a tear. Right now, a 14-second lead. Second place, Martin Manny. Big shout out to everybody listening in, SurfRant.tv. That's where you catch the live stream, ladies and gentlemen. If you're down here in the crowd with us, you want your friends to see you on the live stream, man, tell them to check it out at SurfRant.tv. You can see cool guys up here on the tower like Nicholas Reyes. How you doing today, Nick? Fantastic. You got any favorites here in this junior 13-15 class? Yeah, Casper Konya. I don't know if you just walked up here, but Casper has a huge lead.
He's got a big old truck. He's here, so it's going to be good. I'm going to solve this project.
Guys like that in the future of our sport.
Yeah, well, not only is a good rider, he's a good kid, and he's always nice to everybody in smiling.
Exactly, definitely a great ambassador of the sport. Anybody you want to give a shout out to who might be listening in on the live stream?
I just want to say thank you to Jordan. He's the guy that's with the flyboard exhibition today. And if you guys want to buy some flyboard, we are very huge discount this weekend. Come to me at the AC Flyboard booth, and we'll be at that.
Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, that remark completely unsolicited. Nicholas Reed, it's always good to have you, my friend. Here we go, Casper Konya, the white flag of surrender, as my partner Thumper would say, is out, ladies and gentlemen. And one lap to go for Casper Konya. Martin Manning still with a pole in the water, but he's going to need some divine intervention if he's going to make this happen. I'm just saying. Exactly. And Kanya right now working his way around some back markers right here on the inside bubble, closest to the grandstands. Working on to the chicanes over there, right-hand side of the track. Jasper Kanya. Jasper Kanya, only 14 years fast. And that means he's got another year in this class right here. Picking up an expert limited title yesterday. Got a junior title 2 years ago. And now he's looking for a sponsorship from Quakey Sense and the new Kuta line. That's what I'm talking about. I'm going Kuta all weekend long. And Jasper Kanya through the split one last time. He's working the greens right now. For those of you folks that are watching in at home, the green is the inside split. The blue is the outside split. Left-hand side of the track. That's where we're doing it. So the checkered flag, Bart Seegers, ready to bring it out right now. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Stand up, clap, make some noise for Jasper Kanya! And Special K, looking for his third world title. And you know, this is the kind of kid right here. You can see he's polite. Normally, you're gonna run all the way down to the pitch right now. You're gonna turn in, you're gonna go to inbound. But he is waiting for his friends to come in so he can high-five them. Barton Manny in second place, folks. Boat number 53. And see what I mean? He's waiting. And there we go. A little high five. How about that? That's what it's all about. These kids are setting an example. That's all I gotta say. Just be a warm fuzzy up here. I'm sorry. Angry Bird, Bart Hughes coming in. Curtis Pittman, I believe, unofficially in that third spot, followed by Salman Ahmadi. Ahmadi again in the Put It Out the World Championship. He took home last night. What a cute little guy. Sunchatai ending up in that fifth place position. That's the bomb, Sunchatai. We'll round out your top five. We're going to race number 15, folks. Hope everybody's having an amazing weekend out here. Again, race number 15 is your GP runabout. And as I pointed out earlier, man, time to put your seat backs and tray tables in an upright lock position because we are taking off to Lake Havasu. Taking a look down at that starting line, Eloy J. Casa will be sitting on the inside pole. Boat number 5, he has been the story this week as he's had some issues, mechanical issues here in the past couple of years. But it looks like he's got to dial in. He had to dial in and gone faster earlier this year where he won the International Rallout Grand Prix. And again, I'm saying keep your eyes on boat number 5. He is a prize out there. James Bushel, 9-time world champion. Also, he is going to be all the way on the opposite side of the line. All the way on the right-hand side of the line. Great Britain's James Bushel gets 9 world titles. Hey! You said you wanted a hat. My name's Mike and I deliver. Who else needs a hat out there? You need a hat? There we go. Need a hat? You guys need a hat? Who else needs a hat? Right now, I'm going to pull a hat trick. Hat trick. Who needs a hat out there? All right. All I got to say is this, guys. You make orange look good. Here we go, run them out. GP opens photo number 1. Yoji Kaza, top qualifier. Muhammad Larabi, skinny Mo. Gonna be out there on the K-Dub 6-6. Muhammad Elmaz will join the party out there on the K-Dub 38. Number 20, the Khalid Barabi. Boat number 7 is Jonathan McLagan. Boat number 158, James Bushel. The 217 is Mr. Kangaroo Tom King. Boat number G1 is Aranja Wu. Boat number 9, Sakiho Nakimami. Boat number 60, guys, I don't even know how to pronounce it. Boat number 69, Mike Klippenstein. 200 is Phil Pope. And Phil wants to give a big shout out to everybody in GB listed in. Boat number 86 is June Akoma. Boat number 444, Mohammed Mashin. Boat number 23 is Andre Landley. 7 is Craig Warner. Great to see Craig back out here. And boat number 4, we know him as Skinnyo Erminio Iantosca out of Naples, Florida.
Problems.
every time he comes out here to Lake Havasu, man, they have their stuff dialed in.
Wow, tough break for Georgie.
Yeah, all year they're dialed in. They come out here to the big show and suffer something like that. Once again, it is the KW66 Skinny Mo, your leader out there, right, for the public authorities for youth sports in Kuwait, as well as Telecon, Skinny Mo. Looking for another world title. How many you got right now, Don? You got like 12?
What? What do I have? Besides trouble. No, I can't do that energy miss, man. That's too awesome for me.
That energy miss is awesome.
Uh-huh. Okay, again, Georgi Kasha, who we kind of expected would be dominating this race. Instead, as Mike had said, having some boat issues, more issues than Mike's ex-girlfriend, in fact.
Yeah, that's why she's my ex.
Thank goodness. Anyway, we've got Barabi still leading, boat number 66. It's off that front stretch, George. It is James Bushel, boat number 158, and Colin Barabi, boat number 20. When you've got your head buried underneath the hood, boat number 17 is having that problem right now.
Yeah, I'll take a look down the T-17 and kind of through Chonky.
Was that Rainier? Or, there's two 17s out there. I love how they do that to us.
All these numbers, and we've got a double.
Yards by Aaron Williams.
He rides for Ribbon Curl, Rock Oil, Quakey Sense, and Jeff Porta.
Thank you, Mikey. Get the laps in for this moto. Hopefully, keep him at least somewhere close to the top 10.
Hey, Dalton, by the way, just to let everybody know who's listening in, it's the SurfRant.tv live stream. Sport GP will be coming up next.
World's tiniest numbers is in place.
Man, it is great to have the best seat in the house.
I would tell you what that rider was, but the numbers on the side of his boat are about 3 inches.
Yeah, the story in this one, Skinny Mo out in front and a breakdown or a mechanical issue from Georgi Kasha. Now, let's go back a little bit further here, and we see on the 66, and that's Bushy right now that is reeling him in.
Yeah, he's actually gained a little time on him.
James Bushel, sponsored by SB Components, 158 Performance, and Works Racing this weekend.
Three-time world champion, but you know that Bushy also has had his route of bad luck out of the world finals when
right.
He finally started switching that fate and suddenly the world title started to come pretty fast. So three of them so far
Exactly. Well, he's got two here in the GP class. He's got two in the GP class, but he's got seven other ones. He's a nine-time world champion.
I thought he had three in the GP, so it was two. Thank you. You're awesome. And that's Kaja coming through again.
You know, we're going to have to go down in the pits and get a hold of Yorji Kaza and actually see what the issue was. Obviously, the rope was wound up tighter than the squirrel on the road.
Yeah, well,
I think they're all
lap road. I was going to see it exactly. I was going to